we are starting over a comparative study now of old preparation for civil services and new preparation for civil services. Here, when I will say old preparation, you have to keep in mind that old means prior to 2011. So last exam according to this old syllabus was taken in 2010. For 2011 onwards, examinations changed out. And then minor amendments were carried out in that after 2011. So I will compare old versus new. And then I will explain why I am comparing here. Because it is, what is that? Old was there, this is none of use now. But still I am going to compare. Prior to 2011, there were two papers for prelim. One was general study and another one was optional. So which optional you have to take, that was already asked in prelim exam. And then you have to go for two papers. General study paper was of 150 marks and optional subject was of 300 marks. Depending upon the your cutoff, you are selected for mains. For mains, two languages, obviously for qualifying level, then essay writing 300 marks, then general study paper 1, general study paper 2, and two papers for optional subject. So you have to select there two optional subject. Out of that, one optional subject you have taken for preliminary examination, so that will be there. But apart from that, you have to select one more optional subject. Clear? And then personality test. On basis of cutoff of mains, they will call you for personality test. Now here, very clear thing is there that whatever the wattage was there, that was main for optional subjects. In prelim also optional subject was there, and in mains two optional subjects were there, each of 600 marks. So suppose I am taking history as one optional subject and chemistry as another optional subject. So I have to score 600 marks from history and 600 marks from chemistry. Clear? Now new syllabus in prelim, everybody is of equal level. So no separate papers are there. So it is not that I am preparing for history, somebody else will prepare for economics, third one will prepare for politics, and three different optional subjects will be there. So no, for preliminary examination, everybody is on same ground. So that is main change. Again, so there is wattage for optional subject that is reduced in prelim. For mains also, if you check out, 1200 marks were there for optional subject in old syllabus. In new syllabus, just, I am saying just because as compared to 1200, 500 marks are there for optional. And therefore, need not worry about optional paper. So if the point is that many students are having fear in mind. Okay, this is another question actually. The question is that for mains, insufficient time is there for preparation. The thing is that it's true. Always for any examination, we can't say that I am thoroughly prepared. Let paper be there with me. I am able to solve entire paper. So no. But it may happen that comparatively very less time is available for preparation of mains examination. And therefore many students are having practice that we have to prepare first for mains and then for prelim examination. But I hope that with my knowledge, I will not prefer this practice. Reason number one. That whatever time you are simply wasting on preparation of mains right now is not that important. It is important that you have to focus on prelim examination, because probability of clearing out prelim examination is really less. Previous few years record, you can check out. Approximately 10 lakh students are appearing for exam and 10 to 40,000 students are selected for mains. So we'll get clear cut idea that very, very less probability is there for prelim to mains transaction. Comparatively, mains to personality test transaction personality is very clear. This is about 1/3. Okay, I'm not saying mains examination is easy, but winning probability here for candidate is more. Now the thing is that if mains examination is there, then obviously in old syllabus, that means prior to 2011 rather, the consideration was that you have to prepare for optional subjects, so automatically your optional will be prepared for prelim as well as mains. It's true, but now no need to study about optional while prelim is going on. And in case of mains, only one optional is there. If you check, they have reduced the wattage of optional subject and increased the wattage of general study. So, if you clearly observe, you will get idea that optional subject, what we are taking, usually it is recommended that your graduation subject should be considered as your optional subject. If it is there in the list. If it is not, then you have to select out a subject which is going close, nearby to your subject. But if it is already listed, say for example, I am graduating history, then I must select history as my optional subject because I am having knowledge of that subject till graduation level. If I am graduate in physics, then I must select physics as my graduation subject, as my optional subject. So like that, you have to select. There are students, unnecessarily they will go by certain subject like human anthropology. Why? Because many less students are attempting that, and like that things are there. But what is my suggestion? That please stick to the point. Which subject is very, very close to your graduation subject, or it is your graduation subject, select out that. That means you have studied out till graduation level that subject, and only thing is that you have to revise. And therefore, for mains examination, first problem, that is a study for optional subject, that is, we are saying it is minimized. I'm not saying that solved, but it is minimized. You are considering that already you have studied till graduation level, and we have studied out for final examination with full enthusiasm. And therefore, if you are going to read that books again, you will get idea that yes, everything that is refreshing, it is not that first time you are studying out. Alright, let us, I'm saying this on the assumption that you have studied for your graduation examination, then only thing is that you are refreshing your knowledge. Now, about optional subject, about general study subject. For preparation of prelim, you have studied out a vast thing. That is for preliminary examination, you studied out general study in depth. But at that time, your aim is that you have to go for objective answers. That is making your understanding more perfect. And now thing is that you have to carry out a practice, that is writing skill practice. Whatever your knowledge is there, you have to put in proper way. So what is the essential thing for mains examination is writing practice and not studying out general study entirely again. I may say that refreshing of your preliminary examinations knowledge, but how to write down. So writing practice here is important. So though special study is required, and I'm not talking of my own, you can check out through website of upsc.gov.in, that is government website, official website for this. You can get that entire data over here. They say that the thing is that general study, no need to study out any specific, therefore it is called as general study. You have already studied out in preliminary examination, and therefore writing practice, point wise writing practice, that is obviously required. So what you are going to do after preliminary examination is the writing practice for mains. Then within month or few days, you will get that result. and you will get idea whether you are selected. If you are that fortunate and that hardworking, then your number will be there in selected list. You can now prepare for mains with full enthusiasm. If not, then your study will never go waste. You can again start for preparation of prelim, but now you can focus on writing out the thing. Already, as we discussed earlier videos, that in preparation of prelim, also you have to make your own notes. It is not that just by reading you will get everything. No. So you have to prepare own notes. That technique you have to use again. And instead of now making notes, try to get question answer format notes. Write down. And then that will increase your study. So this is all. We can at least talk about the mains examination. We discussed the comparative study of UPSC prior to 2011 and after 2011. And key factors we have discussed.